Good evening, everyone. Welcome to St. Peter's to Jazz Vespers. Tonight, we are going to celebrate the commemoration of Artissima Bowden. Her commemoration day is tomorrow. In the Episcopal Church, we have Saints' Days, and when we recognize people that have been very important in the life of faith and have made a contribution within society. So we'll learn more about her as we get started this evening. I'm going to fill you in on the rest of that after we hear this next song.
Just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind. I say Georgia, Georgia, a song. Comes as sweet and clear as moonlight through the pines. Now the arms reach out to me. Thank you. out to me. Other eyes smile tenderly. Still in peaceful dreams I see. Georgia on my mind. Just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my
Okay, one guess. Where do you think Artemisia Bowden was born? Georgia. That's right, Georgia. So she was born January 1st, 1879, to parents who were slaves. And her mom died young, and so she and her siblings were sent to an Episcopal boarding school in North Carolina. And there, she went through her education. When she graduated, she became a teacher. Hence, the reason that her commemoration day is this time of year when we're starting school. So many across the country, school kids are beginning a new school year. So she taught for 2 years, and then the bishop of West Texas talked to other bishops, as they do, and was looking for someone to lead an African-American school called St. Philip's, because they'd had a request to provide education for the African-American children in their community. School at that time was rare, especially for girls, but it was particularly rare for African-American children, and it was definitely not, it was separate for sure, and definitely not equal. So Artesimia Bowden agreed to go, and when she got there, she found out that the bishop's idea was to have basic grammar education, and then primarily domestic skills, cooking, cleaning, you know, helping, serving other people. Well, Artesimia Bowden had very different idea about that, and we'll hear about that in a minute. Let us begin with a word of prayer. God is our light and our salvation, our refuge and our stronghold. From the rising of the sun to its setting, we praise your name, O God, for with you is the fountain of life, and in your light we see light. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning you called light into being, and you set lights in the sky to govern night and day. In a pillar of cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night, you led your people into freedom. Enlighten our darkness by the light of your Christ. May your word be a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. For you are merciful, and you love your whole creation. And with all your creatures, we give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you.
This evening are ones chosen for this day of commemoration, that ones that can be selected. This particular reading is from the book of Deuteronomy. Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your might. Keep these words that I am commanding you today in your heart. Recite them to your children, and talk about them when you are at home and when you are away, when you lie down and when you rise. Bind them as a sign on your hand, fix them as an emblem on your forehead, and write them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates. When your children ask you in time to come, what is the meaning of the decrees and the statutes and the ordinances that the Lord our God has commanded you? Then you shall say to your children, we were Pharaoh's slaves in Egypt, but the Lord brought us out of Egypt with a mighty hand. The Lord displayed before our eyes great and awesome signs and wonders against Egypt, against Pharaoh and all his household. He brought us out from there in order to bring us in, to give us the land that he promised on oath to our ancestors. Then the Lord commanded us to observe all these statutes, to fear the Lord our God, for our lasting good, so as to keep us alive, as is now the case. If we diligently observe this entire commandment before the Lord our God, as he has commanded us, we will be in the right. So when Artemisia Bowden arrived in West Texas, and she realized the situation there, it was 1902, she knew that she wasn't going to be able to change the segregation, but she sure could make sure that education was equal. And so she very quickly set about raising the academic standards for this school. So the primary grades, 1 through 5, had the basics, reading, writing, arithmetic, geography. Then the next level, the 6 through 9, she added in the higher math, algebra, geometry, composition, rhetoric, English literature, botany, general history, and civic government. And then she also kept in the industrial department, so the practical things like sewing and cooking, and she added music because she felt music was essential to the soul. So her faith and patience were constantly tested by the discriminatory practices and racial segregation of the South, but she, by her own words, said that she wants, her focus is on the positive rather than the negative. She said, I always anticipate success in any undertaking, never failure. A person who has courage must be full of faith. She was not one to let obstacles of race or gender inhibit her or her students. Thank you. Our second reading is from 2 Timothy. But as for you, continue in what you have learned and firmly believed, knowing from whom you learned it, and how from childhood you have known the sacred writings that are able to instruct you for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. All scripture is inspired by God and is useful for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness, so that everyone who belongs to God may be proficient, equipped for every good work. In the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who is to judge the living and the dead, and in view of his appearing and his kingdom, I solemnly urge you, proclaim the message. Be persistent, whether the time is favorable or unfavorable. Convince, rebuke, and encourage with the utmost patience in teaching. For the time is coming when people will not put up with sound doctrine, but having itching ears, they will accumulate for themselves teachers to suit their own desires, and will turn away from listening to the truth and wander away to myths. As for you, always be sober, endure suffering, do the work of an evangelist, carry out your ministry fully. Well, Artemisia Bowden did that. Her school grew very quickly. Within the first year, she had 70 students. The diocese was not much help. Generally speaking, their finances were a mess, and the money that they did have tended to go to the white congregations and institutions of the diocese. So Artemisia had to spend a lot of time fundraising. She added a boarding school, which brought in more students. She moved the school to the east side of the town, where more of the African Americans lived, when people on the other side of town, where the white folks live, were complaining because the school was growing so big. When the Depression hit, there were difficulties, obviously, with finances, but she continued to push ahead. She started a level of junior college within the school. And then she became hospitalized, probably not surprising. And she had to have a surgery. She had to halt her fundraising, and that was a problem for the school. But she wrote to the bishop, "Of course, I am anxious, but not excited the least bit. I am in God's care and keeping." Well, the diocese continued to put pressure on them. That if they didn't turn things around, they were going to quit supporting the school. And then something really amazing happened. A letter arrived in the mail from the Board of Education. And the Board of Education said that it wanted to accept Ms. Bowden's school, St. Philip's, as into the San Antonio Community College system, and they wanted to keep her as the head of school. So this was huge, because now they were able to continue to receive funding for their school. She went on to become a very prominent member in the community. She was on many boards and provided much support for the African American community to be able to gain a foothold in the economic and civic life of the community. She retired from what was then known as, and still is actually, St. Philip's College in 1954 after 52 years of service. And she told a reporter at that time it was a hard decision for her to decide to retire. She said, "It is not an easy thing for me to separate myself from St. Philip's. To me, it's something like a mother giving her daughter in marriage. I had to pray long and hard for strength to divorce myself from the school. Strength came, and now I am inwardly content and happy." And even after she retired, people say that she would walk along the school grounds and see the students, and she'd tell them, "Stand up. You have so much to live for. Don't slump or walk slowly." And then in 2005, a local paper collected the histories of the school and from former students and compiled them, and many of them said that St. Philip's was an oasis from discrimination, segregation, and lack of opportunity. She's since passed away, but the San Antonio City Council passed a resolution of respect for her. And there's an elementary school named after her and an administration at St. Philip's College that is named after her. And they still celebrate her every year on her commemoration day. Reflecting upon her long career, she said, "Yes, my journey has been over a long and rugged trail. There have been some happy moments, and there were times when I was near despair, from which Providence rescued me. Life has been a glorious opportunity to render service and to make a contribution." Life is filled with challenges and sorrow, but we can rise above it with the help of God and with the example of people like Artemisia Bowden.
Not the pale moon that excites me, that thrills and delights me. Oh no, it's just the nearness of you. Isn't your sweet conversation that brings this sensation? Oh no, it's just the nearness of you. When I'm in your arms and I feel you so close to me, our world is dreams come true. Soft lights to enchant me. If you'd only grant me the right to hold you ever so tight. The nearness of you. To hold you ever so
I invite you to join me in prayer. After each petition, I will say, Lord, in your mercy, I invite you to respond, hear our prayer. Let us pray. God of all blessings, giver of all grace, we thank you for the life, work, and example of your servant, Artemisia Bowden, and her willingness to go far from her home in answering your call to service. Guide us in listening and responding to our own paths of service in this world. Grant us similar virtues of perseverance and determination, of inquiry and excellence, of personal sacrifice and dedication to the well-being of our youth and the breaking down of barriers. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Artemisia Bowden faced prejudice and discrimination that still scars our society today. We pray for your spirit to open our ears and hearts to one another, to banish all prejudice and hatred. Guide us in realizing our blind spots and in being agents for racial healing and equal opportunity for all. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Our world is fraught with division, cultural, political, religious. Deepen our understanding of one another as human beings made in your image. Raise up those with the spirit of Artemisia Bowden, committed to providing education and opportunity, especially for girls and women who in many parts of the world still do not have access to education. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Here in the islands, a time of courage and perseverance and faith is needed with and for our sisters and brothers on Maui. We continue to pray for search and recovery personnel in their difficult work in Lahaina, and for families still waiting word regarding loved ones and friends. Comfort them in their sorrow and assist them in moving through these days. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the protection of firefighters working to contain wildfires still smoldering around the island, and for responders providing food and other necessities, as well as mental health support for those who have been displaced and have suffered such trauma. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the disaster response to run quickly and effectively for those applying for assistance in the loss of their homes and business. Calm their anxious souls with the assurance that you are with them and will guide them through this. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In this start of a new school year, we pray for the children and teens whose education has been interrupted by these wildfires. Guide teachers and administrators as they work to adapt to the physical and emotional implications of this tragedy upon their students and their work environments. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Guide us in protecting the beauty and health of our world while facing that which challenges us with united action and care. Help us to learn the ways to better protect both the environment and human life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We remember before you all who are the poor and neglected, the homeless and destitute, the elderly and sick, and those who have no one to care for them. Bring healing to those who are broken in body or spirit, turning their sorrow into joy. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Bless our musicians and all who fill our souls with beauty and joy. Strengthen them in their gifts and in your spirit moving in and through them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Creator God, you've called us to ventures of which we cannot see the ending, by paths as yet untrodden, through perils unknown. Give us faith to go out with good courage, not knowing where we go, but only that your hand is leading us and your love supporting us. Provide us with that peace which the world cannot give, and a song in our hearts that rings with joy and gratitude. Through Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Corner, Manny Dial, who makes the live streaming possible for all of you at home. Thank you all for being here this evening. Have a restful evening. Aloha.